I was with Moses when he handed down these commandments. I was witness to the covenant. The promise of a holy nation. Help me to forge that nation. To lead your people. To inherit their land.
Joshua!
The Lord brought us out from Egypt. He promised us this land. And soon, it will be ours. Come.
Are you ready?
We'll search the whole city.
Just find me the way in. We must take Jericho. It's all that stands between us and the promised land.
I won't hurt him. Swear.
You're Israelites.
You've heard about us?
You have a God who commands the winds and parts the seas.
He saved us from slavery. We are his chosen.
This whole city is terrified of you. How can we fight a people whose God can do that?
Bang me tight.
Open the door!
Can we get out that way?
restore them if I can.
Come with us.
I can't. My family.
When our army comes, hang this on your door so they will know not to harm you. You'll be passed over.
Tell me, did you find a way in? Is there a weakness?
Not in the walls, but in their hearts. Joshua, we met a woman. She thinks God has taken the city already. The people melt in fear because they know he is with us.
God is with us. But we've still to find a way in.
Army.
What does he ask of us?
The Lord parted the waters for Moses. For you. Split rock. This is what you must do. March around the city once a day with all the armed men. Do this for 6 days. Carry the ark with you. It contains God's commandments. Then, on the seventh day, march around the city 7 times. Then the priests should make a long blast with the ram's horn. As soon as you hear the sound of the trumpet, the people shall shout a great shout.
prostitute and her family may be spared. But God said she must be spared for the help she gave us.
Have entered the promised land, but there are enemies on every side, and a new foe is coming, the Philistines. A 100 years after Joshua, the 12 tribes of Israel have spread out across the promised land. But hostile neighbors surround them. Better armed and better trained, the Philistines are the deadliest threat. Without great leaders like Moses or Joshua to unite them, the Israelites must rely on local heroes, called judges. People like Samson.
Mother, come.
Stop.
I don't know.
You must fight them. It's what God wants you to do, Samson. It's why God created you. Remember what his messenger told me.
Don't be afraid. Though you are barren, God will give you a son.
Thank you.
But listen carefully. There are conditions. See to it that you drink no alcohol and eat nothing unclean. And when your son is born, his hair must never be cut. This will be the sign that the boy is a Nazarite. He is given to God. From his birth to his death, he will begin to deliver Israel from the Philistines.
Duty is to drive the Philistines away.
instead of fighting the Philistines, Samson falls in love and marries one. Let me talk to her.
Of course.
My love, does love not come from God? What would you have me do? Reject the woman I fell in love with just because she's a Philistine?
Will your love protect us from them?
We need to send these Israelites a message, make it clear to them. They cannot take our women. Our people should never mix.
How are we going to get to him?
We're not going to get to him.
Open up!
Where is Samson?
I don't know.
Where is he?
He's not here.
Do it!
Please! No!
You are a disgrace to our people.
Please!
Please, I beg you!
Please! Father!
No, no, no.
Father! No! 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 Please! He's begging you, no! Please, no!
One man did this.
Where is he? His people must know. You!
You will bring Samson to me, and you will do it quickly. And for every day I do not see him, one of you will die. Starting now.
No, 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 please, please, no!
Samson?
Samson. Are you there?
Mother.
wasn't expecting you. Forgive me.
We have come to reason with you, Samson.
Reason?
You must stop the killing. Please. For every Philistine you kill, two more appear, seeking revenge.
As they did to me, so I have done to them.
The Philistines are our rulers now.
Everyone must do what they think is right.
No, Samson. You must do what is right for your people. For God. Not for yourself. You must give yourself up, Samson.
Is this what God wants?
I'm not sure. Sometimes God leads us in ways we cannot see. God will guide your choices.
Teach you and your people a lesson.
I gave myself up to save my people. Will you leave them alone now?
If I had more men, I'd drive you all back into the wilderness where you belong. I'd happily kill all of you.
Is this what you want from me? Guide me, please. Come. Thank you. What is your name?
My name is Delilah.
Samson was given great strength to drive out the Philistines. But now he is distracted by Delilah.
Dagon. God and creator, lord of our land. Deliver into our hands our enemy. Samson, destroyer of our nation.
We have news of Samson. He's got a new woman. A Philistine woman.
Another one. What's her name?
Delilah.
I know her. Bring her to me.
Beguiling as ever.
What do you want?
Well, let's just have a little talk about Samson. An interesting choice. Not one of us, of course. Why are you with him?
Why do you want to know?
Don't tell me you care about him.
Is she in love with him?
Ask him yourself.
He's butchered hundreds of our people.
He's changed. He's a different man since he's met me.
You really believe that? He will go on killing until we find a way to stop him for good. Where does he get his strength? What's his secret?
I don't know. He won't tell me.
Try to convince him.
Have you seen what he's capable of?
Maybe this will help.
Why are you so strong?
God is with me, Delilah. He makes me strong. As weak as everyone else. You don't believe me.
No, Samson. I do.
Jackson. Take him. What have you done? See her again.
Betrayed and blinded, Samson's battle with the Philistines is all but over. And with it, the dreams of an Israelite homeland.
Darkness helps me think. Your God has deserted you and taken your strength with him.
No. I can see him more clearly than ever.
He wants me to destroy you all! Kill him! No!
Samson's sacrifice kills thousands, but he could never defeat the Philistines on his own. The prophet Samuel has urged the people to unite in God's name.
There is no one like the Lord.
But after decades of struggle, he too has failed to halt the Philistines.
Prophet, we await you.
And the people's patience is wearing thin.
So what is it that troubles you?
We are grateful, Prophet. You have led us for many years.
God has led us.
Samuel, you are not as young as you were.
We are worried.
Who will speak to the Lord after you? Who will lead us against the Philistines?
My sons will inherit my place.
Your sons are corrupt.
My sons have been brought up to trust in God and obey his laws. Everything I've done for you, I have done because I walk in God's ways.
We know that they take bribes. Everyone knows it. They shame your good name. So, when you are gone, and the Philistines return, and we look to your sons to call on God, will God answer? No, he will not.
Then what do you want?
A king. As other nations have.
But look what other nations' kings do. They become tyrants. They make slaves of their people.
Not if they are chosen by God. Anointed by his righteous prophet. By you.
You would reject our God. God promised us this land. This is God's kingdom. He is our only king.
You have the ear of the Lord Samuel. You must ask him to choose a king for us.
Leave me alone. All of you. I have given everything. Now they have rejected me. And you, God. But if you say I should give them a king, then of course I will. But who should it be?
Instead of sacrificing the enemy, Saul lets his men keep their plunder.
You have one task, one simple command from God. Destroy everything.
We've followed his commands.
Then what is this bleating of goats in my ears? What is this lowing of cattle and wailing of lambs? Can the dead cry out? And who is this pagan king?
He is to be put to death later.
When the Lord says spare, you spare. When he says kill, Samuel!
You are a prophet, but I am your king.
What the Lord gives,
He can take away.
Are these God's words or yours?
Your descendants could have ruled for over 1,000 years. But today, God has forsaken him.
More divine words.
God has torn your power from you. He wants a man after his own heart.